Today, we are going to study about Chapter 7, that is Medieval India, the Cholas. Who were the Cholas? Cholas were the dynasty that ruled in the Medieval India. In this chapter, we are going to explore about the Chola dynasty, who rule in the middle of India. We'll study about their sources of information, their position, and their administration. The Cholas were the important dynasty of South India. South India covers Vindhyas and river Narmada in south and stretch from east to west along with the Tropic of Cancer. The two well regions of South India which cover the geographical area were the area of North River Krishna Tungabhadra and area lying in the south. The Krishna Tungabhadra region was also known as the Deccan Plateau. South India was ruled by the number of dynasties. The first dynasty was the Rashtrakutas. They ruled in the Deccan in middle of the 8th century to the 10th century. They were overthrown by Chalukyas, who made their independent kingdom called Kalyani. After this, the Pallavs of Kanchi ruled over the Krishna Tungabhadra and overthrew the Pallavs. And at last, their position were taken by the Cholas. These were the four dynasties, the four major dynasties that rule over the South India. Along this, some smaller dynasties also ruled in the parts of South India. Now, what were the four main dynasties that were ruled over the South India? The dynasties were Rashtrakutas, the Chalukyas, the Pallavs, and last the Cholas. Sources of the Chola period. The archaeological sources of the Chola period include inscriptions as well as monuments. First, inscriptions. They were inscribed on the pillars and walls of the temples. The inscriptions provide information about the important achievement of king, important royal orders on land revenue, grants, and donations. The copper plate inscription record grants, the villages or cultivated lands made by the Chola kings. The inscriptions were written in Tamil as well as in Sanskrit also. Some important inscriptions were the Thiruvalangudu copper plate inscription of Rajendra Chola I, the Avil's plates of Sundar Chola, and the Kanyakumari inscription of Veera Rajendra Chola. The Thiruvalangudu copper plate record a grant made by Rajendra Chola. This copper plate was in the shrine of the goddess of Thiruvalangudu. In this, there was a list of the Chola rulers who ruled
over that period of time. Next is Brihadeshwar Temple. It is also an archaeological source of information for the Chola period. Next is the Brihadeshwar Temple. This temple was a masterpiece of the architecture of the Chola kingdom. It was built by Rajaraja I and also known as Rajarajeshwar Temple. He built this temple in the honor of Lord Shiva around 1009 CE. Various achievements of Rajaraja I were inscribed on the walls of the temple. The inner walls of the temple, huge paintings and sculptures are present. The height of the tower is 57 meter high and single block of stone is about 25 feet high and weight is about 80 tons. There is a gateway to the enclosed walls of the temple known as Gopurams. Political history of the Cholas. The Chola dynasty was founded by Vijaya. He was succeeded by his son Aditya I. After Aditya I, his son Parantak I inherited this entire region of Kalahasti and Chennai in the north to Kaveri in the south. His sons Gandhar Aditya and Arinjaya ruled after him. After Sundar Chola succeeded the throne, he succeeded by Uttam Chola. And after Uttam Chola, Rajaraja I ascended the throne. So who was the founder of Chola dynasty? Answer is Vijaya Chola. Rajaraja I, he was the most powerful ruler of the Chola dynasty. Under the reign, the empire reached at high level. He extended his empire up to Kalinga and defeated the Chalukyas. He also flourished the trade through the sea route by Indian and Arabian Ocean. He also built a huge naval fleet and defeat Sri Lanka and Maldives. He campaigned in the different directions and conquered the parts of Travancore, Mysore and Coorg. To which country he spent the huge naval fleet? Ceylon, Sri Lanka and Maldives. Who was ascended the throne after Uttam Chola? Rajaraja I. Now, after Rajaraja I, Rajendra I ascended the throne. Rajendra Chola conquered the territories to the east coast of India through the kingdom of Odisha. And after this, he defeated the ruler of Bengal. He made the new capital called Gangaikonda Cholapuram, made his new capital. This new capital held the administrative work and also gives advantages to the empire. In the south, he conquered Ceylon and invaded the territories of King Sri Vijaya in Malaysia. Under his reign, the Chola kingdom became the most powerful kingdom in South India. And with the help of this conquest, he also stabilized trade relation by stabilizing directing trading links. Chola administration. The inscriptions prove that the Chola was highly organized and efficient kingdom. Public revenue was mainly of kind cash or was collected by village assemblies. Income of public source were custom of tolls, various kind of professions and mines and forest taxes. The Chola army consisted of elephants, cavalry, infantry. They have very well military system. The Velaikars were the bodyguards of the kings. The males were given the title Kshatriya Shikhamani for their bravery. The naval powers of the Cholas were very efficient. They took control over the Chola Mandal and Malabar coast and also influenced around the Bay of Bengal. The village administration was autonomous and self-sufficient. There are three types of village assemblies. First is Ur, second Sabha or Mahasabha, and third is Nagram. The Ur assembly was for common villagers, the Sabha for Brahmins of the villages, and Nagram was for assembly of merchant and traders. What type of assemblies does the village administration had? Three types of assemblies. First is Ur, second Sabha, and third is Nagram. Ur was for common villagers, Sabha for Brahmins, and Nagram for merchants and traders. At central level, the defense, maintenance of internal peace and promotion of general prosperity were responsible. The central government interfered only in the cases of conflict or any exceptional situation. Otherwise, whole administration was controlled by the village assembly. Now, I am asking you some questions. Name the important sources of Cholas. The important sources of Chola period were inscriptions, copper plates, and the monument Brihadeshwar temple. Name the two most important Chola king, Rajaraja I and Rajendra I. Name the main deity that the Chola kings worshipped. Answer is Lord Shiva. Name the new capital founded by Rajendra I. The new capital founded by Rajendra I was Gangaikonda Cholapuram. What is the other name of Brihadeshwar temple? Rajrajeshwar temple. List four dynasties of South India from the middle of the 8th century to 10th century. The four dynasties were Rashtrakutas, Pallavas, Chalukyas and Cholas. Who defeated the king of Bengal? Rajendra I. Who invaded the territories of King Sri Vijay in Malaysia? Answer is Rajendra I. Who developed a huge naval fleet in order to control the flourishing Southeast Asian trade? Answer is Rajaraja I. Now look at this picture shown on your screen and answer the following question. Name the temple. The temple is Brihadeshwar temple. Name the place and the state where this temple is located. It is located in Thanjavur in Tamil Nadu. When and by whom was this temple built? The temple was built by built by Rajraja I and built in 1009 CE. To which deity was this temple dedicated? This temple was dedicated to Lord Shiva. Mention two important features of this temple. First feature is Gopuram and second is Nandi Pavilion.
Now we are taking a glance of the chapter. Medieval India, the Cholas. Dynasties that were ruled over South India. Four dynasties. First is Rajputas, Chalukyas, Pallavas and Cholas. Again I repeat, Rajputas, Chalukyas, Pallavas and Cholas. Sources of information. There are two sources of information. First is inscription and second temple. In inscription, copper plate is made and in temples, Brihadeshwar temple. Founder of the Chola dynasty, Vijaya, he was the founder of Chola dynasty. Important rulers, the two main and important rulers were Rajaraja I and Rajendra I.